Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel of St. Wilfrid's College of Arts, Commerce, Science, Panvel. Today's topic is Organization Development Part 3, that is Lecture 3, presented by Assistant Professor Tapasya Patil, St. Wilfrid's College of Arts, Commerce, Science, Panvel. Now we will be starting with the organizational diagnosis. So what is organizational diagnosis? What is the meaning of organizational diagnosis? Organizational diagnosis is the creative method for getting to know an organization at all levels. Yes, it is a very creative method. Yes, organization should be known at all levels in this, from the surface levels, yes, to the deepest hidden parts that aren't visible to the eye. Yes, each and every corner, each and everything of the organization should be known. Yes, organizational diagnosis. Performing organizational diagnosis is not so far off from a doctor trying to diagnose their patients. Yes, how doctor tries to diagnose their patients. Yes, the reasons they ask, the things the patients have been done, whatever the questions, how the doctor's been asked to the patients. In this way, for the organizational diagnosis, the question, the questionnaire has been asked to the top level management and to the every level of the management has been involved in this, has to answer that questions. Yes, organizational diagnosis is an effective basis of looking at an organization to determine gaps between current and desired performance and how it can achieve its goal. Yes, organizational diagnosis is effective when it is done exactly, when it is effective exactly, when we should fill the gap between what is the current what is the current performance and what is the desired performance, what performance is exactly been going on, and what performance exactly we desire, we expect from the organization. Yes, so the goals could be achieved. Developing an organization is no different. With each iteration of the diagnostic process, so new changes are identified and prioritized. Yes, in the organizational diagnosis, few changes are been identified, exactly that where changes are been required is identified, and it is been taken as a very important part, as and been prioritized. Next, phases of organizational diagnosis. Now, what are the phases of organizational diagnosis? First, we'll see the purpose of diagnosis is to identify the problems of organization. Yes, and the organizational diagnosis process is powerful consciousness raising the activity on its own right. Its main usefulness lies in the action that induces. Now, how is diagnostic cycle? What are the phases in this? First is orientation. Second is goal setting. Third is data gathering. Next is analysis, interpretation, feedback. Next is feedback. Next is action planning. Next is implementation. Next is monitoring. And last is the evaluation. Yes, the orientation has been done. The goal has been set. We need to gather the data. We need to go for the analysis of the data. We need to get the feedback from that data. Action planning should be done. After getting feedback, implementation is important thing. And after implementing, monitoring is also important thing, whether things have been working out or not. And then we can go for the evaluation. So this is exactly the diagnostic cycle for the phases of organizational diagnosis. Next, we are moving with the purpose of organizational diagnosis. Why the organizational diagnosis is needed? What is the purpose? Enhancing the general understanding of functioning of organizations. Yes, to enhance the general understanding and the functioning of the organizations, such a study may aim at enhancing understanding of human behavior through a study of its organization, or to enhance the understanding of society as reflected in organizational life. Next, planning for growth and diversification. Now, an analysis or diagnostic study may be necessary for planning growth, diversification, expansion, etc. Yes, the organization analysis may reveal the strengths that could be used for growth and diversification. Next, improving organizational effectiveness or planning general improvements. Organizational analysis may be used also for improving the general efficiency of the organization. Yes, organizational analysis may be used also for improving the general efficiency of organization. On the basis of diagnosis made out of analysis, action steps could be initiated in terms of toning up administration, introducing new management systems and processes, and reduction of wasteful expenditure. Next, organizational problem solving. Whenever some subsystem departments, units, etc. fall sick or start creating problems, a diagnosis may be taken with a view to identify the source of problem and take corrective action. A sick unit, a bottleneck, communication block, or a poor performing department, frequently occurring conflict between two departments, repeated failures of management system or the organizational process, a frequent violation of organization norm, fall in discipline, reduction in output, absenteeism, increase in conflicts can lead to the need of organizational diagnosis of a part of organization or entire organization. So these are exactly the reasons why the organization goes for the organizational diagnosis. You can see in this point of organizational problem solving. Next, we are moving with the levels of organizational diagnosis. Now, what are the levels of organizational diagnosis? You can see as an inputs part, general environment, industry structure. Now we can see with the design components are exactly what strategy of the organization, if it has been needed to be changed, then that should be found out in the diagnosis and the strategy should be changed. Next, the culture. How is the culture of the organization? That could be diagnosed in this. Next, a technology, whether the technology been implemented or what technologies are been required in the organization just to improve the efficiency and effectivity of employees. Human resource system. Yes, the HR would be diagnosed, human resource systems, and structure. Yes, the organization structure would be diagnosed. So these are five exactly would be diagnosed so that the loopholes, the problems which have been there in the organization could be found out. Like outputs is organization effectiveness. Yes, when these things have been analyzed, diagnosed properly, we can go with outputs as organizational effectiveness. Next, the organization must understand the environment to respond to it effectively while accomplishing its mission. Yes, organization must understand the environment to respond to it effectively. Yes, while accomplishing its mission. This type of organization can be diagnosed at three levels. Now, organization would be diagnosed exactly at three levels, not at one level. It has been diagnosed at three levels. That is organizational level, group level, and individual level. The organizational level is looked at three phases. Which are the three phases? Just we have seen in the diagram are inputs, system designs, and output. Yes, next. The organizational level diagnostic model is another type of diagnostic model that looks at an organization from an external or a high level viewpoint. A similar model can be followed at a more detailed level, which focus on group level diagnosis and individual diagnosis. Yes. Now the model exactly been focuses on which type of diagnosis, both the type of diagnosis at a group level also. And individual level also. Now, techniques of organizational diagnosis. Yes, what are the techniques exactly? Organizational design and development. The OD or an applied behavioral science perspective is more appropriate for discussion here. Hence, in the subsequent part of its unit and the subsequent unit, more details are presented relating to the organizational development. there are many ways of analyzing and diagnosing organizations and their phenomena. The following are the most frequently used methods. Now, what are the methods exactly for diagnosing or analyzing the organizations are? The method first is questionnaires. Yes, we can ask the questionnaires to, at all the levels of the organization, all three levels. Next, interviews, we can take individually group interviews, observation through the observation. As the OD practitioner who goes for an organizational diagnosis can go for an observation, the change agent, the analysis of records, circulars, appraisal reports, and other organizational literature. Yes, so the analysis of what all things can be done as in records, we can say circulars, analysis of appraisal reports of the employees, yes, need to be done. How the employees has been worked through the, annually is been properly seen in that reports. Analysis of hard data of organization and various units. Yes, analysis of hard data of organization is done in the various units. Task forces and task groups. Yes. Task forces and task groups. Problem identification and problem solving workshops. Seminars. Symposia and training program, recording and examining critical incident. Yes, so these are what the techniques of organization development. Next, we are going to organizational renewal. Now, what is organizational renewal? Organizational renewal may be defined as an ongoing process of building innovation and adaptation into the organization. Yes. Organizational renewal is what exactly? An ongoing process of building the innovation. Yes. And adaptation into organization. The organization goes for the innovation. It's the organizational renewal. The renewal dilemma is that stability is necessary, but is also to measure obstruction to change. In business, the term organizational renewal is used to describe the process that empowers all employees of the organization to work together to create the common vision about the organization's purpose and how it will achieve the success. Yes, organizational renewal is very important. If the company is to survive in an increasingly competitive marketplace, the organization must continuously adapt its environment. Yes. See, we could say day by day, the changes has been taken in all the sectors of the organization. Like we can say for an IT, the new technologies has been launched, which has been adopted by many of the organizations. Yes, this is what the organization is going for a renewal. They're accepting the various technologies in the machineries part. We can say for the production, the various German technologies has been implemented by the organizations for what? For getting the work to be effectively and efficiently done. Yes, this is what exactly an organizational renewal. So organization needs to adapt the technologies or whatever things that could be changes according to the time, according to the centuries. So the companies to survive increasingly in the competitive marketplace, the organization must continuously adapt its environment. Without renewal, management cannot maintain excellence. Thank you.